Hey PiWhales community. Welcome back to our channel. We've noticed that only 40.9% of our viewers are subscribed to our YouTube channel, which means that 59.1% of you have not yet subscribed. We want to change that and encourage all of you to hit the subscribe button to stay updated with all of our latest videos. Subscribing to our channel ensures that you never miss a video. It also helps us to create better Pi Network content for you. The more subscribers we have, the more feedback we receive, which allows us to tailor our content to your preferences. So, what are you waiting for? Hit the subscribe button now and don't forget to click the notification bell so you don't miss a video. Hello Pioneers, and welcome to this video about Pi Network's KYC process. In today's video, we will be discussing the cost of KYC and how it affects the Pi Network. As many of you know, Pi Network is a new digital currency that allows users to mine Pi coins on their mobile devices. However, before users can transfer their Pi coins, they need to complete the KYC process. KYC stands for Know Your Customer, and it is a process used to verify the identity of users. The KYC process is crucial for preventing fraud and money laundering, but it can also be costly. Ben of BSC News posted a quick Pi Network KYC thoughts on Twitter. He said, the cost of KYC can range from a couple dollars to $100 per KYC if using a third-party service provider. If even 2 million pioneers apply for KYC, that will cost a minimum of $2 million to the Pi core team if they paid out of pocket. It would likely be higher. Advertising income from the app really wouldn't help solve this problem at all. Asking pioneers to pay would defeat the purpose of making the network fully accessible. They needed to find a way to circumvent the cost, and it is still being developed. It is slow at the moment, let's be patient so that the network can be accessible to everyone. The wait may not be worth it if you are someone that could just pay the fee themselves, but it is 100% worth it for someone who can't. Now, it is important to note that the Pi Network is still in its early stages and is constantly evolving. The team behind Pi Network is aware of the cost of KYC and is working to find a solution. In fact, they have already implemented a system where users can earn Pi coins by referring others to the Pi Network. This referral system allows users to earn Pi coins, which they can use to pay for the KYC process. This is a great way for users to get involved in the Pi Network without having to pay out of pocket for KYC. One of the main goals of Pi Network is to create a digital currency that is accessible to anyone. The Pi Network team understands that not everyone has the resources to pay for KYC, which is why they are working to find a solution. It is important for the Pi Network to be accessible to the people, regardless of their financial situation. By making the network accessible, Pi Network can grow and become a global currency that everyone can use. It is important to be patient when it comes to the Pi Network's KYC. As we mentioned earlier, the Pi Network is still in its early stages, and the team is constantly working to improve the network. While the KYC may be slow at the moment, it is important to remember that the team is working hard to find a solution that will make the process faster. We must be patient so that the network can be accessible to anyone. So, the big question is why it is worth the wait. The wait may not be worth it if you are someone that could just pay the fee themselves, but it is 100% worth it for someone who can't. The Pi Network is a revolutionary idea that has the potential to change the way we think about cryptocurrencies. By being patient and waiting for the KYC to improve, we are contributing to the growth of the network and helping to make it accessible. Pi Network has already attracted millions of users, and with our help, it can continue to grow and become a global cryptocurrency. In conclusion, the KYC process is an important part of Pi Network, and while it may be costly, the team is working to find a solution that will make it accessible. By being patient for the KYC process to improve, we are contributing to the growth of the network. Again, it is important to remember that the Pi Network is still in its early stages and is constantly evolving. The team behind Pi Network is working 24/7 to find solution to any issues that arise and to make the network better for everyone. Thank you for watching, and we hope you found this video informative. Remember to hit the like and share button so that fellow pioneers can also watch. Why Pi Network should implement KYC to all pioneers? As we know, Pi Network is designed to be accessible to anyone, and this includes people who are new to digital or cryptocurrencies. However, this accessibility can also make the network vulnerable to fraud and abuse. KYC is a way to verify the identity of users, which can help to prevent fraud and ensure that the network is being used for legitimate purposes. KYC is also important for compliance with regulations. Many countries have regulations around digital or cryptocurrencies, and compliance with these regulations is important for the long-term viability of the Pi network. By implementing a KYC, the Pi network can ensure the legitimacy and stability of the network. To summarize, implementation of KYC to all Pi users is extremely important for the Pi network, as it can help to prevent fraud and protect the security of user accounts. Without KYC, the Pi network would be more vulnerable to hacking, fraud, and other security breaches. This could undermine the trust of users in the network and have serious consequences for the long-term viability of the Pi network. By implementing a KYC, the Pi network can also demonstrate its commitment to legitimacy and security. This can help to attract more users to the network, which can help to increase the value of the Pi coin and strengthen the overall Pi network ecosystem. Now, what's new? Or what's the latest updates of Pi Network's KYC after the celebration of Pi Day 2023? Let's listen to Dr. Nicholas Kokkolis as he briefly discussed the Pioneer's Mass KYC and Mainnet migration, which play a very important role to launch Open Mainnet in Pi Network.
Now, we need to focus on what the entire Pi community can do together to move the main goals of the enclosed network forward and bring us closer to Open Network. These are just two goals. The first goal is Mass KYC identity verification of the tens of millions of Pioneers, followed by the migration of their mobile mining balances to the Pi blockchain, so people to KYC and move their Pi to the blockchain. And the second goal is the creation of real utilities for the Pi cryptocurrency through the Pi ecosystem, so people can use their Pi for apps, goods, and services. Two goals. We achieve these goals and we take down the mainnet firewall. As part of the first goal, today, the core team is making KYC open for all. To achieve this, we are introducing a tentative KYC program that gives accounts with more complex properties a chance to start their KYC, allowing the algorithm to make additional checks after they have submitted documents and passed the reviews by validators. We are also adding a new feature that allows Pioneers to send mobile notifications to members of their referral and security circles to encourage them to also start their own KYC and migration process. As part of the second goal, utility building, we are releasing a testnet ecosystem interface that showcases testnet community apps. There, Pioneers can explore in-development Pi apps, give feedback to the community app developers, and get a preview of what the mainnet ecosystem may look like. Please exercise caution when trying incomplete apps and report any policy violations as necessary. Thanks to all Pioneers for another great year of Pi Network. Now, more than ever, we are depending on everyone in the Pi community to come together and celebrate towards our shared goals to get us closer to Open Mainnet. Let us see what we can build together.
KYC is a crucial process that verifies your identity and prevents fraud. It is essential to complete KYC to unlock all the features of the Pi network. However, sometimes you may encounter issues while completing KYC or face problems with your Pi account. In this video, we will discuss how to contact the Pi network support team and get your issues resolved. So, how to contact the Pi network support team? Pi Network Pioneers or users can contact the Pi Network support team through various channels, including email, social media, Pi Network app, and Pi Network official website, which is www.minepi.com. Contacting support team in the Pi Mining app is the most efficient way. Users can access the in-app support feature by following simple steps. Firstly, they need to open the Pi Network app on their mobile devices. Then, they can click on the three horizontal lines in the top left corner of the screen, select Support Portal from the drop-down menu, and you will be directed to the Pi Network Support Portal website. Alternatively, users can contact the support team via chat in the Pi Mining app, where all the FAQ or frequently asked questions are displayed. Pioneers or users can choose to tap to go to FAQ section before asking. Users can choose different chat groups and join the conversation within the group. We suggest that you visit the Pi Core Team Mods Q&A group chat for the latest announcements by the founder himself, Dr. Nicholas Kokkolis, and the Pi Core team. What information should you provide when contacting the Pi Network support team? When contacting the Pi Network support team, users should provide as much information as possible to help the support team resolve their problem quickly. Some of the details that users should provide include their Pi Network username or mobile number, the device they are using to access Pi Network, a detailed description of the problem they are facing, any error messages they have received, and screenshots of the error messages or problem they are facing. Providing this information can help the support team diagnose the problem and provide a timely solution. In conclusion, completing KYC is a crucial step in using the Pi Network. However, users may face various problems while completing KYC or accessing Pi Network. If users encounter any issues, it is crucial to contact the Pi Network support team immediately. Recently, Dr. Nicholas Kokolis assured that the KYC issue will be solved before Open Mainnet. Your patience is appreciated. So do not worry if you still not received KYC invitation, because Pi Core team is now working 24/7 to ensure that every Pioneer will get their KYC completed. No Pioneer will be left behind. Now, if you already received KYC invitation, make sure to process that immediately. Get your valid ID ready. And to those, KYC are still pending for reviews, nothing to worry, Pi Core team is now working on the solution. Mass KYC is on its way.
Subscribe to our PiWhales YouTube channel and earn Pi rewards.